few occasions I don't have to wear a suit and can be as scruffy as my sixth form. My name is Patrick O'Connor. I'm the head teacher of Todmorden High School, and I'd like to welcome you to the incredible annual Todmorden event. It's when we've timed it. And I will just set the scene of where the school fits within this, because as the second or third largest employer within the town, also taking in 750 of the young people within the town, we have been positioned and positioned ourselves right at the heart of the work that's going on with the incredible edible Todmorden. And I think it's a really exciting time for the town, for the school at the moment. Can I just ask a question first of all? Just put your hand up if you've not been in a school in the last 10 years. Well, that's quite good, encouraging. I think your hands down. Right. Put your hand up if you went to school. Because our school within Calderdale, we are identified as the worst build in the entire authority, and the priority number one rebuild across the authority when it comes to something called BSF, Building Schools of the Future. And if you live locally, you'll have seen right up until this week in the newspapers how we continue to try and get a new school at Todmorden and another one down the valley at Calder High, and we're working in partnership with the authority and all political parties to try and make that come to fruition. Now, I started in the school 3 years ago, and when I came, it's fair to say the standards were pretty low. It's also to say the community relationships, some things went on, but that was also fairly limited. And the reputation of the school, even though the school thought it was a good school, the community said, well, actually, no. Okay? So I arrived, and there were some challenges there. And the reason I put this up, as you came in, you may have seen or may not have seen, there's a statue at the front of the school entitled Reach Beyond. Jim Knight, who was the Minister for Schools up until last May, unveiled it for us last year. And it really summarises the aspirations of us in our school. A new logo in the top corner, that's meant to symbolise Todd Valley. People say it's too narrow. It had a small T when we first created it, like the London Olympics, and everybody went, ooh, you can't do that. And anyway, we designed it between ourselves as well. And the logo in the middle, some people say it makes you like a sports college because it's sports for all, but for us it symbolised reaching beyond, breaking through this artificial glass ceiling for Todd High students, and really to raise their aspirations. And as a school, it's what we've done. And I want to talk a little bit, first of all, for a few seconds, you'd expect a head teacher to do about what goes on there. The bit that you send your kids to school for, this around results. When we arrived, these were seen as the best results the school had had. All right, we were pleased. The number of students that we had here, so 46% of our students left with the higher grades. Down at the bottom, 96% of students left with at least some GCSE qualification, and the school was pleased at that time because of it. This is the position this year. Our results are up to 65% of the students leaving the higher grades, with English and Maths increased. For 580 Gs, 95, and now 100% of our students leaving the qualifications they need to move on. We're now a good school. Okay, so we can say that and get that bit out of the way. But the school is much more than just a set of results. And this is how we built our success. An incredible edible Todmorden has been a major vehicle in helping us do that. A few moments. These are a few of the things we do within the school. You may have had a tour around already. When I arrived, I had to try and find what would raise the aspirations of the school and turn the school on, because there were some issues with standards of teaching and things that I needed to address. And also with the community bit, I looked to everybody in school to say, do your best. And Tony Himmel Group, Tony's in my Whitcliffe. Tony, our catering manager, just been nominated for a National Education Business Award down at Emirates Stadium next week. Also nominated for the work he's done for the Halifax Courier Awards. We were a finalist in that for the Environmental Community Awards. Just one person of the team, along with Andrea, stood next to my finance and business manager. Neither of them were teachers, who have led a massive chunk of what we've done here, brought the students on, brought the teachers in as well. Yesterday, I'm right in saying this, we've got the Food for Life partnership at the back there, and we were nominated yesterday, or achieved Food for Life flagship school status yesterday. And if you don't know what that means, then you can find out those things there. We have, can't really say this, and I don't know if I'm allowed to say it, but I'm going to say it anyway. We have £750,000, I believe, in our bank account, waiting to be spent. Potentially, there's a big lottery fund we've been given, and that's looking for approval at the moment for the development of the back of the school for a whole host of incredible edible food type of activities, including a fish farm. And you may have seen in school already hydroponics and aquaponics display that's up around. So some really exciting things to go on that are nothing to do with GCSEs. They're to do with life, and it's much more than just doing that. The group in the bottom, we have a group called Leo, if anyone knows about Lions International. Well, we have a junior Leo, the only school, I believe, 11 to 18 school in Yorkshire that has one of these. A group of our students, we have an A-level biology field trip. They went to Kenya, they developed some links, raised money to go along and look at a sustainable project around providing water within that community for the school and orphanage and local community they visited. So we'll look at sustainability in a global perspective as well. And the little boat that's a bit out of perspective is just one of the things of, rather than growing, like the rest of Tom, and flowers, growing food and having berries and things going on the school side. Food have I talked about. One target we do have within school that we have to look towards is something called community cohesion. My biggest vehicle to pulling the community together and us as a school helping with that is around the food hub and the work of Incredible Edible. And all the work that goes on within the school there around engaging the community in extended services or for excellence with our student leadership or even within the curriculum. We had something called Seed to Table last year where the students planted seeds and cultivated and looked after grew and when we the egg crops. So a bit more controversial this year, we had some live eggs. They were followed in a Big Brother style with egg camp. The children saw the match while they were in at lunchtime as they were coming out, and then the great debate came, do we eat them? Or do they become layers for next eggs and whatever else? And that's talking about the ethics around food and sustainable life are right at the heart of what we do again, and it's made the subjects come alive. It's really incredible. And edible. That's Pam, by the way.
That's me, sorry.
And we fall around as a school, right at the heart, I think, of what we do. For the future of Tomlinson, as a high school with 750 people, now I'm still here as the head teacher of a secondary school, there's some stunning work, even better work goes on in our primary schools. It's a real family of school movement. Almost there. Now that very complicated picture there, before I hand over in a second, we developed and done a lot of it through student leadership. And each one of those little boxes is a student leadership pyramid. And we have a series of what we call, you might call them prefects in your day, we call them senior school leaders. And say the mentoring at the top box there, we have Dale over in the corner of the grey jumper. Hello Dale, wasn't going to mention you, but Dale's in charge of mentoring within school as a sixth former and leads a team of about a dozen students who are mentoring younger students who then in turn mentor younger students. We have some training from outside of school to work with that. We run a school council, the Leos, a sports council that develop a lot of the health things we work along with MEND and the Carnegie Obesity Project and a variety of other things through NHS Calderdale. A couple I do want to mention, the Kenya trip I've talked about, links we're developing because they have a similar sort of project with fish farms in Nepal, and also many people within the room here may have been involved in the Polish exchange that went on earlier this year as well, and how the students have become involved in that. Mentioned the school council and the leadership around these issues that we have. SNAG, which is called School Nutrition Action Group, which is part of the Food for Life partnership, where students not only say, the chips are soggy, can we have better pizza, or whatever, as the quite often student voice is, but looking and sampling the food that goes on in, making recommendations, looking at nutritional values, and helping to create those menus along with Tony and the other things we go with in school. And a group called the Go Green Group, led by another senior